Carter, labels was a big concern of yours.
Yes.
And so I take it you support this relabeling, this an opportunity. Is there any concern, though, that this will lessen the accountability, which was such a big part of No Child Left Behind, the rationale for it, and make it easier for schools not to perform as well as they should?
Well, that's a very good question, and a lot of people have asked that question, because specifically you have to do four things as a state to demonstrate mastery in four areas. Number one, we have to have career and college ready standards in place, which we do in Arizona. We're part of the new Common Core standards. We're moving to the PARC assessment here within the next 2 years. We also have to show that we have an accountability system that's in place and working. We have to show that we evaluate teachers and principals based on student data, which we are currently doing. And the fourth piece to it is that we are showing that we are reducing duplicative and overly burdensome regulation on our schools and districts. So if we meet all four of those criteria, then we will receive the waiver. So it's kind of in contrast to, if we opt out, we don't have to do it anymore. We're actually showing that we are doing it. Therefore, we don't have to abide by duplicative and overly burdensome national regulation. So for example, let's take how we label schools right now. A school last year essentially could have received four different labels. It could have been labeled a performing school. It might have also received a letter grade of a C. It might not have made AYP, and it could have been labeled persistently low achieving. Well, as a parent trying to decide where do I want to send my children to school, that's really complicated. And so what you want is basically a simple system to say, this school is doing great work with children, and this is where I want to send my kids. And so if we're able to show leadership in these areas, which I think we will be able to do, the federal government will most likely grant us the waiver. And then also, furthermore, we are going to then streamline our system in Arizona for how we label schools. So originally, when we put forth the school labels on the letter grades, the A, B, C letter grades, we said we were going to phase out the legacy system, the high achieving and excelling labels and so forth. But there's a bill in the legislature this session to actually go on ahead and remove those legacy labels so that we don't have this confusing system for parents.